Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 245. Kind of broad at the shoulders and narrow at the hips. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John. Big Bad John.
Big John.
Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. Didn't say much, kind of quiet and shy. And if you spoke to him at all, you just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans, where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen. And a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
A big bad John.
Big John.
Then came the day at the bottom of the mine when a timber cracked and the men started crying. And the miners were praying and hearts beat fast. And everybody thought they'd breathe their last, except John. Through the dust and the smoke of this man-made hell, walked a giant of a man the miners knew well. Grabbed a sagging timber and gave out a groan, and like a giant oak tree stood there alone. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
A big bad John.
Big John.
And with all of his strength he gave a mighty shove, and then a miner yelled out, "There's light up above." And 20 men scrambled from a would-be grave, and now there's only one left down there to save, Big John. With jacks and timbers, they started back down, and then there came that rumble way down in the ground. The smoke and the gas belched out like that mine, and everybody knew it was the end of the line for Big John.
Big John. Big John.
A big bad John.
Big John.
Now they never reopened that worthless pit. They just placed a marble stand in front of it. These words were written on that stand. At the bottom of this mine lies a big, big man. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
A big bad John.
Big John.
Big bad John.
Big John.
Big bad John.
Big John.